So I just went ahead and unloaded the 450 out the back of the truck. I left it out there last night. It's Monday after the weekend or whatever. And decided I was going to go ahead and slap the 250 back on the little hitch thing so that I can go ride this week. This weekend we're taking the 250 and the four-wheeler to the dunes. Me and my daughter are going to go riding on the dunes. But I just thought I'd look at the hours while I was out here doing stuff. And so we've got 71, almost 72 hours on the 250 and 49.2 on the 450. So 50 hours and 70 hours, 71 hours, almost 72 hours. The hours are racking up, man, racking up. Trying to keep as many hours off of that bike as I can just to keep it fresher for racing this year, since it's all race ready. Trying to get most of the play hours, most any time I'm riding not in a race, I want to be riding this one. So that's why the hours are going up so quick. But still doing great. Haven't had a problem with either one of them that isn't caused by me. So gonna go ahead and load this one up and get it on there. Yeehaw. So just after I got done bragging about how the bikes haven't had any issues or whatever. Isn't that when everything happens? So anyhow, the last time I rode the 250, I noticed that the steering felt very stiff. I just assumed it was too much dust, too much gunk in the steering head or something, and it was just getting bound up, because it has been awful dusty the last couple rides I've ridden it, as you can tell. I mean, the bike is just covered in dust. But I went ahead and took suspension cleaner and brake cleaner both and sprayed in it, and it's not... Like, that right there is actually stuck. I can actually pull on the bike. The bearing rotated now, but I can feel the individual bearings. Like, it gets stiff and then it pops through, and then it gets stiff right there. Pops through. Pops through. Pops through. So the bearings are shot. I gotta get new steering bearings on it. Which, whatever. Truth be told, I had a lot of people tell me when you get a bike, you need to strip it all down, grease all the bearings, and put it all back together. I didn't do any of that. This thing's been ridden for the whatever 72 hours without any of that stuff done. I put on the protection stuff, skid plate and hand guards and stuff like that to protect big parts of the body, the swing arm and all that. But as far as taking it apart and greasing the bearings and the linkage bearings and the wheel bearings, I didn't do any of that. Like, I figured it was all done, good to go, and it lasted a year and a half, 70 hours before, you know, one of the bearings went bad. But I can obviously tell the front end bearings now are not so good. If I let it set for a little bit without moving it and then come back to move it again, it just gets stiff as hell again. So, gonna have to order those up and have somebody press out the old bearings and press in the new ones. Not really sure how that works, is I think I've seen people before, they have to press off the race off the bottom and get the race out of the top. I'm not sure, but yay, another adventure. No big deal, and not saying it's the bike's fault whatsoever. Many of the times that I've worked on it, I've just pressure washed it and then literally fucking let it air dry. So I haven't been trying to prevent rust or anything other than the chain, spray it down with WD-40 or something after washing it just so the chain don't get rusty. But have never really done anything for the bearings. So surprised that the wheel bearings and everything have been as good as they've been. I haven't had a single problem. Yeah, that tire is like solid as solid can be wheel bearing wise from side to side. There's no play, so... Wheel bearings and everything have been super good. Linkage bearings are super good. The steering on this one's the only one acting up. I came over and checked out the 450. It's not acting up. It's nice and smooth. You know, it doesn't have any lockups or anything in it, which this one's on the ground. And I put the 250 up on the stand just because I couldn't tell if it was the carpet, if it was the concrete, or if it was actually something in the steering. So once I got it up here on the stand, now you can really feel that there's something there resisting you turning. Probably not a super bad. I'd probably go out and ride it again, but the last thing I would want to happen is this bearing to lock up the front end and not allow me to turn right before I hit a tree. So probably won't be going for a rip on it this week until we go to the dunes, If I can get all this replaced and done before the dunes, then I'll feel better. If not, then we'll take it to the dunes just like it is, because you don't really have to dodge trees in the dunes. And we'll see how that turns out. Maybe a little sand in those bearings will really help it out. And by the way, this has been to the 250, already went to the dunes last year. We took it on a dunes trip. I don't ever ride in the salt water directly. Like, I don't go out on the beach and ride in the salt water of the ocean. But all the dunes have salt water, you know, right next to them. The dew that comes in the morning and sea spray off the ocean. And nothing really has ever corroded bad on it. So, lucky there. But maybe the bearings got torched. All right, guys. Woo! We're getting into some very weird midweek maintenance this week, boys. So, this weekend, packing up with my daughter and heading to the dunes. We're going to go play in the sand. So, starting to get the trailer loaded up. Got her bike all cleaned up. Somewhat cleaned up. Took it for a ride, made sure it's running. Unfortunately, it gets ridden so little, it actually still has the gas in it from the dunes last year. So, hopefully we can burn a whole tank of gas this year. That'd be great. But, like a typical Honda, a couple pulls on the rope and fires right up. Love that thing. Draining out all the water out the ice chest. Gonna get it stuffed back in there. I got my tools pretty much switched over to my Boxo tools now. This is the secondary tote that I'm gonna have with me. I got the zip ties, all the other stuff, oil, grease gun, coolant, just kind of a general everything. And then I've got more oils, brake fluids and stuff up there in that rack. So I think I pretty much have everything I should need on a general basis. Like, if something big happened to the truck, I probably wouldn't have enough tools, but or enough goodies or whatever. But for just the bikes and the four-wheeler and little stuff, generator, whatever, I think I've got just about everything a guy could want between this box and the Boxo. So the one thing I have noticed about this is it's super convenient that all the boxes, all the trays are laid out perfectly, like organized and stuff. But there's no empty drawer, there's no extra storage, so the top can hold a lot. It's got a deep box on the top. So I can tell already it's going to end up being kind of my catch-all. This stuff here was just temporary. That's going to go in the pickup. But the couplers for my bike, masking tape, electrician's tape, T-wrenches, wire, air gauge, which the air gauge, I really like this one. It's a Tusk one. It's a max of 15 pounds. So setting your air pressure on a tubeless system when I always am, you know, like it right there, that was my reading for the race up in Bellingham. So I was right at 9 PSI. So to do that, I can do it super accurate with this, where like the digital one down in there doesn't read that accurate from what I've messed with it so far. And some of the other bigger tire gauges I've seen aren't that intricate in the small. Like 0 to 10 PSI is like this big of an area. So it's really hard to get it right. I like this one because it allows you to get it set just right down at low pressure. So probably keep using that one. So this just ends up being a catch-all. Everything gets thrown on the top of it. You can carry extra tools that way, so that's a good thing. But at the same time, it makes getting into the top tools a little less easy. But I don't know, maybe at some point I will make a rack or something on the door, put some U-bolts or something where you can just slide these in to a set of rings or something, so that these are on the maybe the back doors of the trailer. Just be able to put in some rings and have all the T-wrenches hanging on here all the time. I'm not really sure. I'm not sure exactly how I want to do it. I'd like to have it more like this, a toolbox where I can take it out and move it. If I want to work on something away from the trailer, I can. If I start bolting stuff to the trailer to hold tools, well, then I got to pretty much stay near the trailer, which isn't a big deal. Most of the time I am, but options. All right, four-wheeler loaded, bike loaded, and today's just Wednesday, and it sounds like tomorrow I'm going to go ahead and take the 250, that's what this is in there, 250, 450 still here. We're going to go ahead and take the 250, and my dad's going to go riding with me up the OHV. He's going to bring his four-wheeler, and we're going to go riding. Probably just a tootle along. I might take the camera with me. Don't know. Maybe we can get off into some trails that we don't normally get to. I want to try and find a different loop So the loop that we've been running, got it down pretty good up there on the trails. I want to try and either connect it to make a bigger loop, and instead of 20 miles, do like a 40 mile loop, or just find a different loop to do just for variety. I don't want to keep running the same trails over and over, because the racing that we do is not like that. The first lap, you've never seen the trail before most of the time, unless you've went out and walked, you know, the 6 to 11 mile trail, depending on how long the trail is. But your first lap, everything is, you're clueless. You don't know where anything is. So I'd prefer to run some of the trails up in the woods like that. Blind, not accustomed to them, not sure which corners come next. The trails we've been running, I'm pretty accustomed to now. I know where the corners are at. I know which way to turn and everything. So I need to get off onto some fresh stuff and get out of that stuff. So we'll see if we can find some of that tomorrow. All right, guys. Have a good night.